In this video, we're going to have a look at having two charts open side by side in the same knt2 file. So it may be that you're designing an item that needs to have more than one chart, and you would find it helpful to have them all in the same chart file with the same key. If you've designed one of your charts and you now wish to start a second chart, you can insert a blank chart into your chart file. So we come to Insert in the main menu and Insert Chart. And as you can see, a very similar dialog box opens to that you see when you first create a chart in Stitchmastery. So I'll just call this one Part 2 and I'll make it flat to match. There's no reason that both charts should be the same. You can set up the chart to be exactly how you want it. Click OK. And you can see that Stitchmastery has put the second chart side by side to my first chart. And looking at the outline view, you'll see that the key is sitting at the right of the screen. It may be useful to point out at this point that there is the option to zoom to fit, which brings everything in your workspace into full view. And something else to point out is that in the output text box, we now have the written instructions for both of the charts. So my first chart here hasn't got a title, but we have the written instructions. And then chart part two, as I've just called the new one, is here. And at the moment it's set up as a stockinette chart. You can see that this chart originally was used as an example for showing the grid highlighting tools. So all of the charts are using this extra highlighting. Doesn't have any bearing on this particular tutorial. So the next way you might wish to have two charts in the same file would be if you've already designed a chart and you want to bring it into this file. And that is also very easy to do. So we want to open the other chart. You can either use the open icon in the icon menu or come into File and Open. And we'll grab this one here. So Stitchmastery has opened the second chart file, and I've obviously designed it at some point using a different stitch library that's not on this machine, but that's okay, we'll just ignore that. It's defaulted to a normal default stitch library. So if I wish to copy this chart into the knt2 file called Grid Highlighting, then I want to select the chart. And you can either do this by clicking in the corner of the chart, clear of the column numbers and the row numbers, or you can use the select tool, select all charts, and you want to copy. So again, there's the copy icon. There's obviously commonly used keyboard shortcuts, Command and C or Control and C, or you can use edit and copy. Come back to the other knt2 file and making sure that nothing is selected, we're just going to go straight to paste, and again we have an icon for that, and Stitchmastery has popped the third chart in line with the other two charts. And you'll spot that in the key we now have the additional stitches from this chart listed in the key automatically. And as before, our chart is called Nessie, and in the output text we have the written instructions. Now you'll note that there's no instruction to use the colour green, and that's because at the moment this chart file is not set up to include the yarn colour, but we'll set that up. So we come to Diagram, Edit Diagram Properties, Written Instructions, and check the box that says Include Colour for Written Instructions. And automatically you'll see that we then have the instruction to knit in green and change to white. But this is one example why you may actually prefer to have two different charts in separate knt2 files, because you now see that for the other two charts we've got the instruction to knit in white. So if it was the case that you were designing something where you were going to have a band of colour work in one area but you wanted other charts to display lace or texture or cables, then it may be better to just have your colour work band in a separate file, and you won't have that problem with the yarn colour coming into the written instruction where you don't need it. So something else you might want to do now that you've got some charts side by side is to copy and paste some of your chart into another. So we'll use the Marquee Select tool up here in the icon bar. You'll see we've changed to a crosshair cursor. What's important is to make sure that the entirety of the cells you want to copy are within the bounds of this crosshair. So if I wish to copy this section of triangle around these stitches, then I want to be completely clear of the stitches when I start to click and drag to draw the outline. So making sure that the dotted lines are falling within the surrounding stitches and not the actual stitches I want to copy. So I've clicked and held and drag, and I let go of the mouse or keypad, and you can see stitches that I want to copy are grayed out. And again, we can use the copy icon or the keyboard control. So that's copied to the clipboard. Change back to the arrow select tool, and you're choosing the top left stitch of what you've copied as the destination. So click on that cell in the new chart, and then we can use the paste icon, and you'll see it copies in and updates the written instructions straight away. What happens if you choose a cell that is not going to give you the full, so we had 5 stitches wide here. If I choose the second cell from the right, then I obviously don't have 5 cells going along to the right, but I can still paste, and the program will just paste a section of that selection. Hopefully that's useful.